I feel like confidence is everything. If you don't have confidence, you're not gonna make it. Three tips for how you can gain more confidence. First is the most important one. You've got to really watch out for the stuff that you say to your own self, because you hear yourself more than you hear anybody else. And if you're constantly beating on yourself and talking negatively about yourself, you're gonna have low self-esteem issues. Whether it's like open for people to be able to see it or not. And I think that's the one that I struggled with the most, because I was the meanest person to myself. Like, I'm that person that if I don't do things right, I'm constantly there thinking about it. I'll think about it. And I would go to bed and rehearse the whole day and play it like play by play. Like, I'm like, oh my God, why did I say that? Why did I do that? Oh my God, you could have said this differently. You could have done this differently. You could have, and you're beating yourself and beating yourself and beating yourself. And you don't realize that over time, it causes you to have low self-esteem. It causes you to look down upon yourself. And this is not even anybody else looking down on you and anybody else talking badly about you. This is you doing it to yourself. I think that the first step to confidence is really taking time to like think for yourself. Like, how do you talk to yourself? Do you say positive things to yourself on the inside? Do you feel good about the things that you say to yourself? Like, what can you change that is like, what are the things that you can change to make yourself feel better on the inside, right? So maybe instead of telling yourself, I feel so stupid, tell yourself, I'm able and I'm capable of doing more. I'm able and I'm capable of doing better. I know I can do better than this. I know I'm capable of so much more. When you say stuff that is affirmative, that's in a positive thing, it completely cancels out the negative. And this takes so much work, you guys. It takes work to do this. But if you do the work, it definitely results in a more positive outlook and a positive attitude long run, right? And the second tip that I have is you've got to get around people that are confident as well. When I'm talking about confidence, I'm talking about people that are not afraid to be themselves. I'm talking about people that are bold, people that don't hesitate to do things, or people that they love themselves so much that they're not afraid to love you, and they're not afraid to be, to allow you to be you in their presence, right? One of the things that used to bother me the most were people that tried to stop me from being me. You know, you get around certain people and they'd be like, why do you do that? Can you not do that? Like, just don't do that. Like, you can't do that around me. Oh my God, stop telling me what I can and cannot do. I don't want to be around you anyways. If I can't be 100% myself, don't nobody want to be around you. Like, I'll find new friends. Thank you. There's plenty of people in this world. Don't ever feel like just because one person diminishes you and the one person makes you feel some type of way and stuff that you're like somehow depleted, or because you don't have the acceptance or something like that, something's wrong with you. No, listen, there's close to going on 8 billion people in the world, okay? I'll find new friends. Thank you. I will find them. Thank you. Nguanu. Waka komots. Go. All right? But you Nigerian. That was so Nigerian. That was such a Nigerian thing to do. Like, yo, carry yourself. Carry your trouble. Komots. I don't want the drama. I don't want your trouble. Carry it away. Nobody needs it. I don't want it. Thank you. Take that stuff with you. Nobody likes those kinds of people, okay? And the third tip that I can give you, if you look the part, you feel the part. If you look the part, you feel the part. So whatever you can do to put yourself in that state of mind, do it. Do it. What gives you the most confidence? When I'm wearing heels, you can't tell me nothing. I shut it down. If I walk into the room, you can't tell me nothing. If I'm wearing heels, I did come to play. If I'm wearing heels, I did not come to play. That's just how I roll. Shoes just make me feel, heels make me feel like oomph. Suddenly you walk with more confidence. I think all girls should learn how to walk in heels. There's just something about when you're in a really, really nice pair of heels that makes you feel very like elegant and very, you know, uppity. You become uppity overnight. Like, it's like, dude, you can't tell the person anything. When you dress nice, it makes you feel good. You're gonna exude that. And when you exude that, it literally starts to play back. It plays back for you. So whatever it is that you start to feel will stick. Okay? You know, like how people always say you gotta fake it till you make it? That's literally what it is. So you have to look the part. Look confident. Stand up tall. Hold your shoulders back. Like, you really gotta stand up tall. Don't let anybody make you slouch and do... I'm only slouching right now because I'm being very lazy. No, but don't make people pull you out of that space of where you're supposed to feel good about yourself and feel good for yourself. You can't give people permission. Don't give them the right to do that to you. Because the only person that can make you feel that way is you. And you shouldn't even do that to yourself. Do you get what I'm saying? So those are my three tips for feeling more confident in yourself. And those three tips literally translate to self-love. They definitely translate to self-love. Because a person who has love is confident and sure in themselves. How you become sure in yourself is you take the time. You have to take the time to work on yourself. You can't expect that it's just gonna happen or just sit there and wish for it. You actually have to do the work. You have to be mindful of your thoughts, like I said. Like, that's the first step. Be mindful of your thoughts. If you catch yourself telling yourself something negative, stop yourself right then and there and say, no, I am no longer gonna choose to look at myself this way because I'm better than this. And the truth is, you are better than that. You're way better than that. We all are better than that. If you're created in the image and the likeness of God, you are God. You are God. Do you understand? Like, you are created in His image. You are Him. You are Him. And you're supposed to feel the best of the best of the best of the best. That's what you are. You're not competing with anybody. You're not struggling to try to be like somebody else. You're supposed to be you. You're authentically supposed to be you, unapologetically. And if that doesn't work for some people, boo-boo, be you. Be fly, be dope. Allow them to keep on moving. And sometimes you got to tell people, listen, I don't appreciate how you treat me. This relationship is no longer serving me. And so I've got to move on now because you don't bring out the best in me. You don't allow for me to shine. You don't allow for me to be who God created me to be. Therefore, I can't. We got to part ways. I love you, but I'll be over there. You stay over here, but I'll be over there. You have to say that sometimes. And people feel bad because it's like, oh, then I'm not going to have any friends. The next video I make, I'll tell you how to be by yourself and not feel lonely. Because for some reason, people feel like if you're by yourself, it means you're lonely. They're not the same thing. I love my alone time. Like, I'm alone right now. Like, everybody's sleeping. I love alone time. It doesn't make me lonely. Loneliness and alone is not the same thing. And that's another video that I'll make another day. But I really just wanted to make this video to encourage anybody that might be going through, like, self-esteem issues or you're just lacking self-confidence and stuff. You've got to find that confidence within yourself because you are deserving of a better life. And that starts with you wanting to be confident, but not just wanting to be confident. Be willing to put in the work it takes to become confident. My confidence that I have today, I've had to struggle to gain these confidence. Like, I literally had to struggle. I had to know who I am. And I had to get away from some people. I had to get away from people that are constantly putting me down. And there's people that put you down, not because it makes them feel better or whatever. They just don't know. They just don't know that they're putting you down. And sometimes they don't know that that's how it's translating for you. And so you don't, I don't hold it against people. I just can't be in your environment or your space for too long. I love people that I can get around and it makes me feel good. And I can encourage them and motivate them. And I'm constantly encouraging people because I know we are all meant for more. So remember that you are meant for more and you're supposed to be confident in who you are because you are created in the image and the likeness of God. You are God. Do you understand? You are God. You are Him. If I need to serve God, I need to serve you. Because when I serve you, I'm serving God. That's literally what that means, okay? So I hope this video helped somebody and helped you like maybe like feel a little bit better and stuff. It's very easy to find confidence, okay? When you start doing that work, confidence will show up. When you get confident friends will show up. more positive people will show up in your life, and you don't have to be miserable or go through the stuff that you're going through right now if you are going through something, okay? I will talk to you guys in another video. Be sure to subscribe, like, and share. And yeah. Bye, guys.